Hello, welcome to another video about Visual Lancer. This video is part two of three videos discussing IBMI application modernization. Part one of the videos discussed these four lists. It indicated they are often viewed by others in your organization from these perspectives. It also suggested that the new business value defined on these lists was your modernization project's critical success factor. This presentation is about some of the things you might be able to add to these lists. The starting point for this video may be something you are familiar with. It is a simple and representational 5250 application. This 5250 application can handle customers, orders, and products. You probably have 5250 applications something like this. Your IT staff might have written the original application, or you might have purchased a packaged solution. You might now maintain the application with in-house staff, or it is maintained by someone else. You might not even have the source code. All of that is immaterial in terms of this presentation because everything I'm going to show you can be used in all those situations. You know the saying, you can't teach an old dog new tricks? Well, if you think of these 5250 screens as some old dogs, then I am going to show you how you can teach them some new tricks. This is a web page displayed in the Chrome web browser. It was created by a Visual Lancer product named RAMP, where RAMP is an acronym for Rapid Application Modernization Process. I'll talk more about how RAMP works later on. For the moment, I'm simply going to use this modernized application that RAMP has created. Working as an end user, I log on and start using this modernized 5250 application. I can very quickly navigate to the Orders application area. As an end user involved in order fulfillment, I always start my day by checking on orders that are now overdue. The modernized application allows me to quickly find orders in ways that the 5250 application never did. After checking the details of some orders, I decide to look at overdue things from the customer point of view. Considerations about how important customers are and how much credit they have available will go into how I decide to prioritize order fulfillment today. Then I start to consider product availability. Again, my modernized application allows me to quickly locate products in ways that the 5250 application never did. Some products are out of stock and some have replacements, so I do some poking around in them for a while, all the time planning out what orders we can fulfill today and in what order. You can see that this modernized application architecture allows me to easily work with orders, products and customers concurrently, which is useful because these application areas are at the core of my working day. Now I am going to auto-arrange everything I am working on and put on my IBMI application developer hat. I feel I need to do this because what you are seeing might be a bit different to anything you have seen before and quite different to what you are expecting. Here are the three 5250 maintenance screens I showed you earlier. Orders, customers, and products. Just to be clear, these panes are 5250 screens displayed by running 5250 interactive jobs in Qinter. They are perfectly normal 5250 sessions. They are just being presented and managed in a way that you may not have seen or considered before. Notice how the labels on the 5250 screens are blue? I've done that on purpose so that you can always tell whether you are seeing a new application component or an existing 5250 application component being reused. For purposes of this presentation, you will just have to take my word that we can show the 5250 screens like this and make them behave in these new ways. So what about the other non-5250 things you are seeing on this screen? Well, these are called filters, and I'll explain some more about them in a few minutes. And the whole screen is organized by something called the Visual Lancer Framework. That's essentially what video 3 in this series is about. For the moment, it probably suffices to say that the framework organizes and manages navigation amongst all of your application components in these panes. You don't have to code anything to make that happen. It's a built-in capability of the framework. Now that you have seen the basic features of an application modernized by RAMP, I'm going to look in some more detail at things that will add further value to your modernization project. One way to add some value to your 5250 applications is to adorn the screen with GUI controls, like push buttons, radio buttons, drop downs, images, colors, etc. Here is the original 5250 product maintenance screen. And here is my new product maintenance screen after it has been partially adorned. You can see date controls, checkboxes, drop-downs, grip boxes, etc. There are two things to consider about the adornment of this 5250 screen. First, it's relatively expensive to do detailed adornment on a 5250 screen. It is expensive to initially implement, and then expensive to test, and later on expensive to maintain. So unless some level of adornment is automatically applied to your 5250 screens, you really need to do the basic math of hours per screen times number of screens plus testing time to get a handle on the true adornment cost. The other issue with adornment is that used by itself, it adds little or no business value. The result may be that the users of your post-modernization application do not consider it much of a step forward because it does nothing to make their working days better or faster. Visual LANSA does screen adornment, and most of our competitors do it as well in some form or another. I don't want to actually say that 5250 screen adornment is all a bit of a yawn, so let's just leave adornment behind and move beyond it to things that do deliver clear and demonstrable business value. A small but significant value you can easily add to a modernized 5250 application is enhanced prompting. The simplest example is attaching calendar prompts to date fields like this. You can also use simple drop-downs like this. Or you can start to use power prompters like these. The simple ones act much like drop-downs. However, the hazardous material prompt is smart because it allows me to instantly search within all the hazmat codes like this. Here I search the available codes for the one containing the word air. Even a simple calculator attached to a numeric input field can add value to the application. One of the features of RAMP is that it allows prompters to be automatically attached to fields by inference, like date fields, or generically by simply applying a symbolic name to the field. For most organizations using IBM iServers, the days of dedicated 5250 data entry staff are long gone. The people using your 5250 application these days are typically also users of smartphones, email, Skype or FaceTime, Facebook, as well as office productivity tools like Microsoft Word, Excel and PowerPoint. That means that they know how to use computers and have higher expectations of them than 5250 application users in the past may have had. I believe that RAMP's architecture and inherent support for multitasking end users, which I've already demonstrated, lays the foundation for you to deliver modernized 5250 applications that align with both the abilities and the expectations of modern computer users. In other words, it can deliver new capabilities that will unquestionably make their working lives better. Making lists of things is a very common way that business processes are driven. For example, imagine I am an end user involved in purchasing. Notice that I can make lists of products that are out of stock or approaching reorder level, etc. These features allow me to make lists that directly support my job, in other words, the business processes that I perform every day. Different end users may be provided with different lists according to their jobs, or even an ability to customize what appears in their lists. Technically speaking, there are some things that I need to explain. This is what RAMP calls a filter. It filters products according to end-user-specified criteria and produces lists of matching products. Once I have a list of products, I can look at the details of each product using my repurposed 5250 application screen. I could even look at the details of multiple products at the same time and compare them side by side. If we quickly look back at the underpinning 5250 application, you can see that it could only do this. You enter a product number, press enter, and it displays a product. However, when that 5250 application is teamed up with a filter, then it can suddenly do a whole lot more. The filter has added significant capability and business value to that existing 5250 application. It's important to note at this point that this new capability was added to the 5250 application without changing it in any way. The non-intrusive way that RAMP does this means you can even do this type of thing to 5250 applications that you don't have the source code for. By the way, there is also an automatic RAMP feature that allows me to send any list to Microsoft Excel, maybe for some further processing, or as input to some external business process, or simply to email to someone else. So in summary, RAMP filters and lists can add significant value to existing 5250 applications by allowing you to better support end-user business processes in ways that are only really limited by your imagination. It's common for business processes to interact with multiple systems. Sometimes the business processes are on the same computer system, and sometimes they are spread across multiple computer systems and even organizations. I'm going to use two examples of these types of business processes and show how RAMP might allow them to be integrated into a modernized 5250 application to enhance the quality and the speed of the associated business processes. We maintain customer details on our IBM ICE server. However, customer credit status details are actually provided to us by a third-party vendor named CCESP. When customers are new or exceed their credit limit, our staff need to check their current credit status. At the moment, our staff access a website provided by CCESP, the third-party credit check organisation. However, CCESP also provide a web service that I can integrate directly into my modernised 5250 application, maybe something like this. Here I do three quick credit checks, one of which fails because the CCESP server is not available at that moment. As a second example, we keep product information on our IBM iServer, and I can access that through a classical 5250 interface. We also keep a lot, and I mean a lot, of additional GS1 product information in an application that runs on our Windows servers. So using RAMP, I could easily attach the GS1 product information to the 5250 information like this. Here I am answering a customer question about hazmat codes used on bills of lading, because they are different to those used in other application areas. Sometimes I don't need to integrate external resources. Sometimes I already have all the information I need and just want to use it in new ways. For example, I might attach some sales history numbers and graphs to my customer details screen like this. This sort of additional information may allow our staff to better understand the relative importance of a customer to our business. Here, all the information already existed in my DB2 database. I just needed to collate it in a new way to present a new view of the customer. It's important to note that you can add capability like this to any 5250 application, regardless of whether you have the source code or not. Now I am going to add a completely new capability to the details we store about products in our 5250 application. I'm going to allow documents to be attached to products, things like fact sheets, price lists, etc. Instead of storing the documents on relatively expensive IBM IIFS disk drives, I'm going to store them in folders on our Windows servers. So the 5250 product inquiry is further modernized by a new tab, Documents, that might work something like this. Note how I can display or download documents for further processing. Again, you can add this type of extended capability to any existing 5250 application without changing it, even if you don't have the source code. The new documents capability is fairly easy to imagine because it is essentially a new feature added to the existing products application. However, RAMP can add new capabilities to the 5250 RPG programs themselves. It can, quite literally, teach your 5250 RPG programs to do things they have not been programmed to do. RAMP can do that because it surrounds each 5250 screen with layers that can communicate with each other, something that you might be able to visualize like this. Using those layers, you can teach the 5250 program to do things that it was not designed to do. First, let's quickly review the 5250 order maintenance program. Note that it does not have any function keys or program coding that allows it to call the customer maintenance program. However, the modernized versions of those programs can do exactly that. The orders application can tell the customer application to display the order customer's details so that the address details can be compared. This is done by using the Show Customer button. To demonstrate how such a RAMP capability could be used, imagine that the orders and customers applications both store customer address details, and that keeping them aligned is an annoying, error-prone, but important business process. Now notice how the orders and customers applications both have an align button, which adds a new capability that the underpinning 5250 application was never coded to handle. Here I am displaying an order placed by customer 107, Gary Jones, but the address details stored against the order and against the customer are different, so I click Align Customer to align and update the customer details. I can even reverse this process and change the address details on the customer screen and automatically align with the order screen. This change makes the manual address alignment check semi-automatic, faster and much more accurate. In this scenario, these simple buttons would definitely improve some end users' working days. I can push this envelope a bit further and implement a fully automatic change. Watch what happens when I change the phone numbers in either of the modernized 5250 screens. This example, more than any of the others, demonstrates how old dog 5250 applications can be taught completely new tricks, and without changing a single line of code in the 5250 application. I hope this video has shown you some of the ways that you can add value to your existing 5250 applications by using LANSA's RAMP tool. However, being able to do that using RAMP is just a small part of LANSA's overall value proposition. If you are interested in that, please view part 3 in this video series, which is about how your modernized 5250 application components and brand new application components can work seamlessly together. It's really about life after 5250 applications. Thank you for your attention.